In this video, we're going to discuss natural ways to reverse polycystic ovarian syndrome. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Zarowski, and welcome back to the channel. Now, as always, if you're new to the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that bell notification, and be sure to join our notification community. That way, it can help you excel your health and your life. In this video, we are uncovering the natural PCOS treatment. Now, when we look at PCOS, this is something that a lot of women are suffering from, and a lot of women are suffering unknowingly, and then they go and they get conventional treatment. The conventional treatment goes and just covers up the different symptoms that they're having, but it doesn't get to the root cause of the actual problem. So what we're going to do in this video is teach you the root cause of this issue, teach you the natural methods that you need to know, the best natural methods in order to reverse PCOS and do it successfully, because many women are reversing PCOS very, very successfully, and you can too. But let's go ahead and first talk about what is PCOS. Now, PCOS stands for polycystic ovarian syndrome. Polycystic just means many cysts within the ovaries. When you have many cysts within your ovaries, they don't function right, okay? Essentially what happens, you have estrogen that goes low, you have progesterone that goes low, you have luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormones that are all decreased within the female body. Now, what also happens is androgens go higher, okay? Androgens are a male hormone, which causes male hormone symptoms in females, like hair growth on the face, okay? So what we have to do is we have to make sure that we are, you know, aware of this, because the symptoms are not good at all, especially for, you know, women who are just trying to live a normal life. It's typically ages 15 to 44 that you are going to experience this issue. Up to 25% of women have this. So it's estimated that up to 25% of women have this, 70% of women have been diagnosed with it successfully that have it, and 30% of the women who have it unknowingly and don't know why they're having all these miserable symptoms. And like I said too, many cysts on the ovaries. Now let's talk about what causes it, because this is important, because like I said, a lot of people are going and getting conventional treatments, but they don't know why it happened, they don't know, you know, what to do about it naturally, they just know, here, take these different pills for it, but here's the deal. If we can understand what the cause was, now we can go in and start making changes in our lifestyle so that we can go in and really go and focus on reversing this issue. First is insulin resistance. This is the major, major player here. It's estimated that 70% of women who have PCOS have insulin resistance. If you just watched my other video that I did on insulin resistance where I break it all down for you and you think that this may be an issue, by the way, you do want to check this video out. I'll put it in the link below. But if you look at that video, basically what I had said, if you have prediabetes, insulin resistance, it causes PCOS. And so very important topic there when it comes to PCOS. Inflammation, so widespread chronic inflammatory problems throughout the entire body. This will lead to it. It also leads to many other things like heart disease and cancer. So it's nothing to just, you know, skim over here. We want to make sure that if we have inflammation, we're working to stop the inflammation. Genetics. Now, they say genetics is a decent player in this PCOS issue, but here's the deal. When we look at genetics, it makes you more prone to having it, but it doesn't necessarily cause it. Now, when we look at the genetics, a lot of people will go, well, you know, it's genetics, so it's just something that I'm going to have and there's nothing I can do about it. And then they just go the conventional treatment route. But here's the deal, is that genetics, the way I always like to describe it, is genetics is the loaded gun. It's the lifestyle that you choose that is going to pull the trigger. So you may be more susceptible to heart disease, to PCOS, to, you know, all these different issues, these different health issues. But what you can do is you can live a better lifestyle in order to not really trigger that gene, okay? So if you have a genetic susceptibility to this issue, then you want to make sure you're doing all the right things to not really trigger that gene. And so genetics is something that can make you more prone to it, but it's not going to alone cause it. Now, next is overweight. Okay, so it's estimated that 80% of women who have PCOS are overweight or obese. And so this is also a major player. And obviously, if we look at insulin resistance, overweight, and then unhealthy lifestyle through eating a lot of carbohydrates, lots of sugar, poor quality diet, you know, you can see how this all really plays into this whole thing of PCOS. And it all comes really down to a problem with insulin resistance. Now, let's talk about the symptoms, because I mentioned there's a lot of symptoms involved, a lot of symptoms that are not pretty if you're a female. First of all, if irregular periods is an issue, it's estimated that a woman who has PCOS has on average about 8 cycles per year. So irregular periods and typically less. Acne, hair loss, facial hair, so that means you start to have that facial hair growth. Once again, not a pleasant symptom. Really heavy bleeding during your cycles. Infertility is a major issue. A lot of women who are trying to get pregnant have PCOS and they just cannot do so because the hormones are all messed up and the ovaries aren't functioning as they should. So infertility is a major issue here. Weight gain, okay, we just talked about how there's an issue. 80% of women who have PCOS are overweight, but also a symptom of having PCOS is more weight gain because it's messing up your hormones. Sleep apnea, can't sleep at night, very painful cycles. This is very typical. So a lot of women who are having PCOS, they're taking Tylenol and all types of painkillers during their cycles. Depression, because it's messing with your hormones again, and hormone imbalance. So it constantly drives that hormonal imbalance issue. Now let's talk about how to reverse it, okay? Because this is the important part, right? I mean, we can talk about the symptoms, we can talk about the causes, we can talk about what it is, but at the end of the day, you're like, how do you reverse this thing? Now, when we look at traditional methods, this is what I see people going and getting from the traditional doctors, right? They go in and they get a diabetes medication, and that's basically focusing on bringing down those insulin levels, bringing down that blood sugar, and so that's what they're doing in that realm. And then the other thing that I see them going and doing is giving hormone replacement therapy, where you're getting progesterone and estrogen and basically trying to bring those levels back up, okay? Once again, when we look at taking that method, it solves a problem in the here and now, but it doesn't actually get to the root cause of the issue. And it also is going to just cover up the real problem, okay? But what we want to do is actually go in and reverse the problem, get to the root cause. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the best natural methods. This is very important. Now, if you were to come into my clinic, this is what we would do essentially right here, okay? First of all, we're going to start with diet. We're going to follow a diet that would be good for, let's say, a diabetic, someone who has pre-diabetes, someone who is insulin resistant. Best diet for that is going to be the ketogenic diet or a good, healthy, low-carb diet, getting 100 grams of carbohydrates or less per day. So we want to make sure that we're following that good low-carb diet. Keto is really amazing here. Now, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go and focus on exercise. Exercise is very important. It goes and helps lower blood sugar. It lowers insulin levels. It helps you lose weight, okay? It's doing all the things and reversing all the problems that are causing PCOS. So we want to follow a good quality diet. We want to exercise. Next thing we want to do is do intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is going to really help drive down blood sugar levels. If you've heard me talk about this before, we want to make sure that we're using intermittent fasting as a way to really heal the insulin receptors. If we do so, you're going to get really great results because it's also going to downregulate some inflammation. If you're not familiar with intermittent fasting, I'll put a link right up here in the corner and also in the description below to a video that I did that explains everything you need to know about intermittent fasting. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to focus on balancing the female hormones. Very important here. We want to make sure that we're balancing estrogen, progesterone, and all the hormones involved. And we don't want to use the different methods like using hormone replacement therapy. We actually want to go in and use natural nutrients, herbs, vitamins in order to create balance. And so we use a supplement called Female Balance, and it works very well. And I'll put links in the description. Now, the next thing we're going to want to do is use a formula called Insulin Balance. Now, Insulin Balance helps drive down the blood sugar and ultimately drives down the insulin levels. If we can accomplish both of those things, then essentially what we're going to do is see much better results in reversing this issue. So I'll put links to both of those in the description below, and I'll put links to all the different resources that you're going to need in order to reverse this issue. So we look at PCOS. Once again, it is something that can easily be reversed, but what you have to do is just make the proper changes and get to the root cause of it. So be sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends. A lot of women are suffering from this issue and they don't know the proper natural methods in order to actually reverse it. So share it with your friends. If you have any questions, comments, put it down here in the comment section below. And then if you haven't done so yet, subscribe to my channel. I'd appreciate that. And check out my other videos on how you can improve your health. I'll see you in the next video.